Greetings, seekers of weird and wonderful cinema. Welcome back to Vault of the Killer Bees. This is the place where we celebrate genre films that lie just outside the mainstream. Now, this week, we're going to take a little bit of a detour, not necessarily focusing on films, but actually the man behind the films, particularly the Full Moon and Empire Film Moon and Empire Studios, and that gentleman is none other than Charles Band, and you may remember him as the creator of the Puppetmaster series, as well as Ghoulies, the original Troll movie, not Troll 2, one of the worst bad, so good, bad movies ever made, but the first one with Phil Fondacaro and one of the very first roles of Julia Louis-Dreyfus. Now, Confessions of a Puppet Master was recently released. It was released in November of last year, so it's a fairly new publication. It's a really fun memoir, as it says on the cover here. It's a Hollywood memoir of ghouls, guts, and gonzo filmmaking. This was written by Charles Band, of course, with help by screenwriter Adam Felber. And this tells it actually takes you on a journey throughout Charles Band's life, starting from childhood, his childhood in Italy, and going all the way up until the end of 2020. And I really wish this had a little more of some more behind the scenes stuff about various films. It does go into some of the trivia behind, like, Puppetmaster and Ghoulies, of course, and Troll, as I mentioned, but it really doesn't have any sort of the juicy sort of, behind the scenes stories of making a lot of the films and how that process went about. But then again, as it says on the cover, it's more of a memoir. So you get like a brief overview of Charles Band's history of filmmaking. Now, I did mention it doesn't have a lot of the trivia that goes into the making of the films. It could have at least been a little more expanded, and that I wouldn't have minded at least, about maybe 60 more pages in this book. But that being said, there was so much stuff to cover. This is a great introduction into Charles Band's history and his influence on genre films. There's been so much stuff that the average film buff probably wouldn't be aware that he's had his hands in. In fact, he actually got his start in filmmaking, appearing as the sidekick to Steve Reeves in an Italian Hercules movie, and that way back in the late 50s, early 60s. In fact, there's a picture in the book of him with Steve Reeves. And if you aren't familiar with Steve Reeves or his sort of oeuvre of films, they are sort of the precursors to the modern sword and sorcery fantasy movies that you would have seen with Conan, with Arnold Schwarzenegger and Beastmaster, those type of movies. But of course, they were made in the 60s and that. And Steve Reeves was, how can I say this? Sort of like a living action figure. He was just like a huge, like, muscular guy. But anyway, getting away from Steve Reeves and back to Charles Band, the book itself, Confessions of a Puppet Master, as I mentioned, is a memoir it does delve into a lot of the sort of trials and tribulations that Charles Band had in continuing to make a film career outside of the mainstream Hollywood business model. It did help that his father, Albert Band, did have some connections to both Hollywood and the international film market. But that being said, those connections only went so far. Charles Band, on the other hand, had to make his own sort of roads into the filmmaking world himself. And oh man, he's had a very, very storied career that is comparable to that of Roger Corman, otherwise known as the King of the Bees. But whereas Roger Corman claims to have made 500 movies, well, he actually has made 500 movies, but claims to have never lost a dime. Unfortunately, Charles Band cannot say the same thing. I mean, he's made close to 300 movies, but unfortunately, there's been some times where he's hasn't been that much of a shrewd businessman, preferring creativity over the actual sort of number crunching, as it were, or actually getting involved in some kind of dubious business relationships, not on his end, but just with people that were not necessarily looking out for his best interests. That being said, that adds just another layer of interest to this really, really fascinating book filled with different little stories about how the films came to be, not necessarily how they were made, as I mentioned before. And one of the interesting things in this book is the fact that actually Charles Band actually bought a castle in Italy. And it was Castle Giovi, and it was in the Umbria region of Italy. And Charles Band has always been a fan of Italy ever since he was a child. As I mentioned before, he was part of a Steve Reeves production over there in Italy, and his father, Albert Band, was a filmmaker over there. So when Charles Band was contacted by a friend of his, Rolando, that Castle Giovi was available for purchase in Italy. Of course, Charles Band was very, very hesitant. It's like, wait a second, I'm not going to have enough money to buy this huge castle. Why are you telling me about this? But his friend Rolando said, well, wait a second, I've got an inside deal. I know exactly what the auctioneer is going to be doing, and he's going to be doing a sort of a Italian ritual that a lot of people really don't know about unless you're an Italian citizen. And that ritual involved three matches. And the first match, when it is lit, it talks about the history of the place that is up for sale. And then that match goes when that match is burnt. The second match is lit, and it tells about the assets of the property up for sale. That match goes out, and then when the third match is lit, that is when the actual auction begins. And whoever has the last bid in as soon as the match goes out, that is who ends up with the final bid of the property and gets the property, no matter how many other bids have come in or anything like that. That is the Italian tradition. And Charles Band was like, okay, that's great. Why are you telling me this? Turns out that Rolando knew exactly which matches that the auctioneer was going to use and had bought a whole box of them and spent an afternoon timing the matches and told Charles Band, it's like, okay, just go ahead and send me the deposit money, and I'll make sure you get the castle. And sure enough, he did. The matches were brought out. The tradition was was kept, and the various people that were coming around from the world that were actually in attendance to the auction were unfamiliar with the process. But luckily, Rolando was, and as soon as the third match, just before it goes out, he yelled out a million lira, which equals $550,000 in that particular time period's exchange rate. And sure enough, boom, Charles Band became the owner of Castel Giove in Italy. And it was a huge property, and he held parties there. He lived there for some time, but because the castle was so huge that he actually used it as a film set, at least, you know, the lower parts of it and some of the towers, that sort of thing. And you can see that in multiple movies of his, including Skullheads and most notably Stuart Gordon's Castle Freak. So if you find that story interesting, The Confessions of a Puppet Master has other stories that are along the same vein, including, as it says on the cover, it's got mentions of Marilyn Monroe, Demi Moore, Helen Hunt, Bill Maher, whose first film was Cannibal Women in the Avocado Jungle of Death. It's a really fun movie. John Carpenter is also in the book, and Gary Busey on a sugar high during the filming of his iconic role as the Ginger Dead Man. Now, Confessions of a Puppet Master is available in a hardback currently for $27.99, and you can find it on sale through Amazon and various online book retailers. But there's also a great Audible version of it narrated by Charles Band himself. And that, if you're looking for a fun read, it comes in at a breezy 275 pages. There are little sidebars about various films, including Crawl Space with Klaus Kinski and Tourist Trap, and all of these films that you're bound to recognize. Like, wait a second, I didn't know he did that. And that, it's a fun read. I really, really enjoyed it. I'm going to have a full written review on scififorme.com in the upcoming week if you'd like a little more in-depth knowledge about the book. But yes, this is definitely, definitely a fun book to check out if you're a fan of filmmaking, a fan of B-movies, or just a fan of really, really good storytelling. And that's all I have for you this week with Vault of the Killer Bees. And that, thanks for joining me. And we will see you next week when we journey back to the vault to find the hidden gems. So good, they're bad. And so bad, they're good. Have a great weekend.
Copyright 2022 by Flaming Dog Media, LLC. All rights reserved. No portion of this program may be retransmitted without the express written consent of Flaming Dog Media. You're watching Sci-Fi for Me TV, delivering the multiverse since 2009.